Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about Internet of Things. So here is the first diagram which I have made to explain the concept. Actually, the Internet of Things is an integration of machines, which include basically machine learning, that explains how can we train a machine to learn from the input we provide to it. For example, if there is a system and we are providing it some data from the sensors, then how can that system learn that what data is being provided to it and how to analyze it and react to it? Then another concept involved is in IoT is the standards. Now what is this standard means? That since IoT is a relatively new concept, so there is a problem that there are not any fixed standards so that we can follow. That means according to the system requirements and the needs, everyone designs his own IoT system. So overall, globally there is lack of any standard. Then third is the intelligence and embedded system. So here we want to say that whatever system we are making, it has to solve a real life problem where the data given to it actually makes the machine to think and react to the input in the similar way as we humans do. Then there comes connectivity, control and automation. So as we all know that in Internet of Things, a system consists of many subparts. For example, there is a controller and many sensors are attached to it. So how these sensors are providing the input or taking the output from it, what technology are they using, whether it is Bluetooth or wireless or wired, and how it is controlled means the speed, and how it is made automatic. For example, in the latest system we see that the system design automatically takes the input from the sensors, processes it and generates output and uploads it to a cloud sort of thing. So this IoT term, Internet of Things term, today is being replaced by IOE, that stands for Internet of Everything, because now not only the systems but we humans have also become an integral part of these systems. And now since we have provided the intelligence also to the system, so it is called as Internet of Everything. Now here we are going to discuss some applications, real life applications, where this IoT or IoE things are used. So starting from the basic agriculture point of view, we can see there are many systems such as smart irrigation, smart monitoring systems, crop monitoring systems, automatic irrigation system, or supplying nutrients or water to the fields, or using image processing we can analyze the crop health, and the system itself can decide that okay, which part of the field is lacking in some nutrients, or what type of diseases are there in the crops. Then second is the surveillance system, where we see that this basically deals with the monitoring systems including cameras and other systems. For example, we have nowadays till now we have been using normal CCTV cameras, which are devices that are used for recording, and some human beings are required at the other end so that they can analyze that recording and give the necessary action. But now today those CCTV cameras are replaced by smart systems, where the camera or the monitoring device not only records the data, but also generates alerts and takes necessary action. For example, in traffic lights nowadays, any over speeding vehicle is detected, then they automatically inform the nearest police station, or they issue a digital e-challan sort of thing to the vehicle owner. That involves a number of processes. For example, analyzing the speed and then tracking the vehicle number and then sending the output or the action to the nearest police station, traffic controller, or the vehicle owner. Then, for example, we have already seen the use of smart robots, especially the unmanned air vehicles, UAVs, which we usually see. Now they are used for video recording, smart surveillance, and crop monitoring, as well as analyzing the natural disasters, for example, earthquake or cyclone, or weather monitoring. These things are made easy using such smart robot systems, and it consists of these smart robots are themselves a Internet of Things system. They consist of many sensors, self-controllability, and other things. Then we have features such as this Internet of Things system provide digital safety and decision making. So by digital safety we mean that the data provided by the machines or generated from the machines are automatically updated on cloud, that is secured. And decision making is that, as I have discussed, that they generate alerts. For example, in home automation systems, if the user is out of the home and he has left some of the appliances on by mistake, then he can switch it off even from remote place using his mobile or any other remote control systems. Then another major area where this Internet of Things is used is the healthcare. Nowadays, medical science has made a very huge progress, and this electronics and embedded system technology have become a great integral part of such smart healthcare systems. Right from the medical equipments, devices, sensors, we can now have technologies such as CT scan, MRI scan, full body x-rays. All such things are performed so efficiently and in an easy manner. Nowadays, most of the people don't even need to go to hospital. Even there are many mobile applications where the healthcare apps have been issued so that every user can take care of his health by using a simple mobile app. A single mobile app will take care of his blood pressure, heartbeat, fever, body temperature, and all these kind of activities. So these all systems have turned our life so easy, and that's why this Internet of Things or Internet of Everything has become so important today. So now we are going to discuss something related to an example of IoT system, which is called multi-purpose smart surveillance system. So the top left block shows the applications where it can be used. It includes smart cities, smart buildings, and home surveillance. As we all know that since Digital India initiative has been taken in our country, so there this system can be of very useful. For example, if there are families where only elderly people are living alone in the home. So such smart surveillance system can be incorporated in such homes, and if any accident or mishappening takes place in the absence of owner, then the camera can not only detect but also alert the user about that accident, and the necessary action can be taken in time. Then another major application where it can be used is the border surveillance. Now why I have used this border surveillance system, because the features which are included in this smart surveillance are not only recording, but there are many image processing techniques such as defogging. For example, if the border is in Himalayan side region, then there we face much fog and other stormy climatic condition. So such smart systems which are integrated with defogging algorithms can be used for such border surveillance system. Now what are the key features which are special in this multi-purpose smart surveillance system? First is that it is integrable to novel technologies. For example, it can be used with drones and electric vehicles. So now how it can be used is that, for example, if we consider the electric vehicle case, so nowadays the smart vehicles are there. There are automatic GPS systems and automatic control, automatic driving systems, automatic braking systems also. So they all can be integrated with a camera, and the processing is made such a fast that it can take the necessary action to avoid accidental cases. For example, if any unknown vehicle or some object, or for example any animal crosses the way, then it can put the emergency brakes and save the precious lives. Then another features which are included in such a smart surveillance system is that they use edge computing, because for cloud computing based system such an fast processing speed is not possible. So by edge computing we means that the camera is to be interfaced with some sort of microcontroller or hardware system which can process the recorded data with the camera itself. There is no need to upload the data on the cloud every time, only the necessary data. For example, if some accident is reported or some alert is being generated, then that data only can be uploaded on cloud. Otherwise the real-time processing is to be done on edge only. Edge here means that the hardware. And another advantage, this edge computing provides the security issues. For example, cloud-based systems can be hacked easily. So there the home surveillance system or other security system, they can, if they are hacked, then it poses a threat to security. And hence edge computing provides more secured, efficient and reliable surveillance systems. So that's all for IoT based systems. Thank you.